You know I'm in Trenton, man. Shout out to my nigga Biggie Budds, nigga. You we out here?
Out here,
shout out to Biggie, man. Got shit on lock. I'm Biggie Budds, huh?
Tell me how you've been embraced by the hip hop generation as far as having your brand. You up here in Trenton, New Jersey. Got a relationship with my man Big Who, official lyricist, MC, well traveled. Tell me how the industry accepting Biggie Budds.
Well, you know, I mean, like I said, you know, I mean, I've been out here in the town for a while, you know what I'm saying? I used to see Who all the time out west, you know what I'm saying, shooting his videos out there, posted up in the hood, showing love and shit, you know what I'm saying? He definitely plugged me in with the people, you know what I'm saying? Then my people, Alamo, DJ Alamo, you know what I'm saying? I you know what I mean? Be out there with him in Miami a lot, you know what I'm saying? And then he was definitely fucking with the bug, you know what I'm saying? So he was just like, you know, oh, you need to tap in with my mans out there in Philly. So I was like, you know what? Yeah, take that out there to him, you know what I'm saying? So once Gillie had got it, he fucked with it, you know what I'm saying? He definitely came down to the block party to, you know what I mean, represent the 420 wave, but we had it on the 16th, you know, because the whole wave 420 had dropped.
Gil came down here?
Yeah, Gillie came down, you know what I mean, showed some love, came, smoked, scene was good, we had a little vibe, you know what I'm saying? Then that happened. So then, you know, my boy Ooh, you know what I'm saying, he went out there, the Yonkers or whatever, hollered at the boy, he had sent them down there with some, you know, some packs of the Biggie Bud movement, so they was fucking with it, so you know, he let me know, so you know, the next time he went down there, you know the boy had to shoot down there with it, holler at Kiss, you know what I'm saying, Kiss was definitely fucking with it, you know what I'm saying, he was out there. Went to the Bronx, had A Buggy and them niggas out there, everybody smoking, getting high, feeling the wave, you know what I'm saying? So, right. Like, you know, they definitely fucking with it, you know. I was out there with the Coogi on, representing Biggie, you feel me? They fucked with it.
No doubt. Incredible. If you're tuning to me, you watching Gully TV, I got a special guest. I think this is my first event. Journey into horticulture on my platform. You know what I'm saying? Them other niggas is rappers and shit. Hakeem and, you know, Yuck Mouth. Why don't you introduce yourself, big guy?
Yo, it's your boy Biggie Budds, you know what I'm saying? He down here at NJ Weed Man's with it, you know what I mean? Official gas packs, you know what I'm saying? You already know. Originally, I'm from Brooklyn, Brownsville. I'm just out here in Trenton. Been out here for a little bit, you know, I'm just grinding, getting to it, you know, networking. Trying to put this Biggie Bud brand out there.
Right.
Show motherfuckers, you know, gas is out here in Trenton, you feel me?
How long has weed been legalized out here?
I'm saying it's been out here legalized for about, this is about to be the first year, you know what I'm saying, right here, you know? So, you know, they ain't stopped our movement. We've been doing it for about a couple years now, you know what I'm saying? It's just made it legal now, just, you know, basically expanded what we've been doing, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, and made it easier for us to do it, you know what I mean?
No doubt. So, was it the logical thing to launch it in New Jersey? New Jersey went legal before New York, right? New York ain't legal yet, is it?
No, I'm not too sure. Probably, I think they is too, you know what I mean? They should, I don't know if they, you know what I mean, you know, passed it over yet, you know, about writing over the paperwork, but I know right. They should be just as legal as we are, you know what I'm saying?
Tell me about the brand. Tell me exactly what's in that bag.
Know what I'm saying? It's some Red Bull right here. Get up close. You know what I'm saying? Nice gas right here. Straight. All my weed is basically imported, man. I don't fuck with nothing local. Nothing on this side. You know what I'm saying? I fuck with motherfuckers imported in Oregon. You know what I'm saying? Seattle Bay Area.
Right.
You know? And anybody that do fuck with local, they definitely get their shit imported just as well. You know what I'm saying? Like, I only deal with nothing local.
I smell that shit. I smell it from over here. I smell it.
Crazy.
Is this I smelled it since you opened the bag. Is this one strain or you got multiple strains under this Biggie Budds?
Like, underneath Biggie brand. Buds, man.
That look
we got
good
about 20 flavors, man. You come down to the shop, man, it's always about 20 flavors. We always switching up. Every other day is something new down there for you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't continue to smoke the same weed. I'm constantly switching up. No matter how good the weed is to me, like, I can't continue smoking the same strain.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I'm always switching up Bud just because of that, you know what I mean? Like, so, like, when you come down here, I'm always going to provide different flavors, you know what I'm saying? In all brackets, from the 40s to the 60s, you know what I'm saying? Like,
out of, you said you got about 20, you said you got about 20 joints?
Yeah, that's about how many I put out there. I got more than that, but that's how many I put on the table at one time, you know what I'm saying?
Of them 20, if you were an MC, which of them 20 strains would be your Illmatic? What's the Illmatic pack? What's your Reasonable Doubt pack? I need the number
right
one.
Right now, sitting on that table right now, that Red Bull, you know what I'm saying? That's definitely one of them, that Larry Bird. That's definitely a hitter, you know what I'm saying? You know, I fucks with them too heavy. You know?
I'm real particular about, you know, especially if I can choose my weeds and shit. I don't be wanting to go to sleep and shit like that.
That's that indica, you know what I'm saying? You like sativas and shit like
love
that.
Love sativa.
You know what I mean? Like, that's my only fuck with sativa, like, in the crack in the morning, you know what I'm saying? As soon as I wake up.
Oh, so you trying to put a motherfucker to sleep with this shit, man?
Like, indica, after I drop the kids off, I'm smoking indica and hybrids, you know what I'm saying? I like to be relaxed and chill, you feel me? That's right. The TV shit, be having a motherfucker, or you know what I mean, nervous and shit behind the wheel, walking hot, you feel me, or talking.
I need that creative way.
I like to be laid back and chill, you know what I'm saying? Like,
it get me going, man. I work with computers.
So you definitely got to fuck with that sativa shit, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, like, some sativas, I only do sativa early in the morning, you know what I'm saying, just to get me moving, you feel me? Like, other than that, it's hybrids and indica.
So, you don't consider sativa worth branding?
I'm saying, I got sativas, you know what I'm saying? I sell for the people, you feel me?
Right.
Like, I'm going to supply what the people want. If people want sativa, I'm going to get some good sativa. I use sativa just early in the morning, just like, you know what I mean? I be riding around, like I said, I mean, I get nervous. That shit be fucking having me paranoid and shit when I'm behind the wheel, or, you feel me? Hot and shit, so like, you know what I mean, I just deal with that in the morning to get me moving, you know what I'm saying, like, that's it, you know. But everybody else, like the working field, they definitely love sativa, because you know, you can go to work, get high on lunch break, come back, move around, motherfucker can't really look at him and be like, nah, he high, you know what I'm saying, because you still able to act, you know what I mean, move around, be active. Now you smoking indica, you coming in there all slow motion, you know what I'm saying? Motherfucker like, oh, this nigga high right now, you know what I mean? So like, yeah, the working field, they definitely love the sativa.
Love it myself. Tell me about the weed scene growing up in Brownsville. You been smoking weed that long?
Yeah, I've been smoking weed since like high school, you know what I mean? At first, I was like a late bloomer, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, I was playing basketball and football and shit, so, you know, I ain't want that to interfere. I didn't want that to interfere, you know what I'm saying, with what I was doing, you know what I mean, athletic-wise, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I was around it a lot, but then I started smoking more like my senior year, you know what I'm saying? Then it was over, you know what I mean? I was just smoking throughout college, you know what I'm saying? And it was just like, I couldn't wake up without it, you know what I mean? Like, motherfuckers just had to smoke. You know
there
was
some signature brands that was only available in like New York. Chocolate. Branson, and
that's that old school strain.
Yeah,
I don't really like deal with that old school. You know what I mean? A lot of people come down, they be asking for the sour.
Yeah, I was getting to that.
Lab,
I was about to ask you about it.
The haze, and you know what I mean? Like, that's old to me. I like the new shit. You know what I'm saying? I ain't stuck back in the day. Like, I tell motherfucker, you want some shit like that? Just go to your neighborhood and try to find
shit.
Go find something. Go look for me to serve you that, unless it's some like new type of haze. Like, you looking for some like straight up like raw haze, like, nah, I got it, you know what I mean? Like, if I could find a good batch, I'll definitely, you know what I'm saying,
right,
provide it. But it's hard to find that, you know what I mean, that particular one that everybody remember from back in the day, you know what I'm saying?
So yeah, that's like, gone.
All that is gone. It's gonna be something new with it. It's gonna be Ghost Train haze, or you know what I'm saying,
yeah.
Amnesia haze, you know what I'm saying, Sweet Berry haze. They ain't gonna be just straight, yo, here go haze. You know what I mean?
I asked for some sour diesel in the dispensary my first time in Cali. I'm thinking about
they done mix sour with so many different
thinking about trends. It on the plane.
We got sour,
when I get out
cookies,
there,
sour glue.
They looked at me like I was from outer space. They were like, why you want that? They like, we got all of this. Like,
that's how
they
I
knew I wasn't from out there.
Somebody coming in, like, some old head coming in, like, yo, you got lamb's breath? I'll be looking at them like, what? Dog, look at all these strands. You see the list right there, man. Ain't nobody got no old back in the day strands. And besides, it ain't gonna come out the same way it was back then. You know what I mean? It's
right.
Gonna be new. You know what I'm saying? New and improved. You know?
Tell me how you going about marketing this brand besides appearing on Gully TV. You got a digital app? You got anything going on online?
You know what I'm saying? You know, I just got the right now. You know, I got the street team. You know what I'm saying? I got right here, you know. I got Instagram, you feel me? I got a lot of people that fucks with me that's, you know what I mean, pushing it out there, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, this all came upon 1 year, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? You gotta crawl before you walk, you know what I'm saying? Everything I'm learning step by step, you know what I'm saying?
How many Coogis you rotating right now?
I got like a whole dresser full, like, you know what I'm saying, Coogis. Like, every time they pop up on my Instagram or email, I'm on there
copping
them shits quick, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was in love with Coogis since I was a young nigga, you know what I'm saying? My cousins, I used to see them niggas, they used to get a lot of money, be dressed, you know what I'm saying? They had them shits, you know what I'm saying, when I was a young boy, seeing Biggie with them shits, you know what I'm saying? I always, you know what I mean? So once I got, you know what I mean, older and got my type, you know what I mean, my bread up, you know what I mean, it was only right, you feel me? Like, I'm still out there, you know, so I'm copping it, you know what I mean? Like, motherfuckers might say it's played out. I just tell them, motherfucker, you can't afford it.
Nah. Every time I see them hooded joints, I try to grab one. I'm looking for a multicolored joint. You know the joint I'm talking about.
Yeah, I be on. You just gotta hit their website. Their website be up there, you know what I'm saying? They be still doing their numbers up there with the sweaters, you know?
No doubt. What's the ticket on them these days?
Well, my size is about 800. Yeah, they run about like 4-5, I think.
Yeah.
And they're like average size. But once you start hitting like 4-5, 6X, you're gonna run like $800. You know what I'm saying?
$8. How is people, after they see this interview, how were they able to contact you?
Through Instagram or just coming down here, you know what I'm saying? I'm here Monday through Friday, 10 to 9, you know what I'm saying?
If you don't mind, share the significance of this building that we shooting this film.
You know what I'm saying? We here at the joint in front of City Hall, you know what I'm saying? Downtown Trenton, New Jersey, 322 East State Street, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, right in front of City Hall, there's a restaurant called The Joint. Come in, purchase some food, get a ticket to come to the back. Purchase some weed, or you could just skip that and go straight to the back and pay $5, you know? You get a chance to get over 40 different varieties of flavors and edibles, all that shit, mushrooms, whatever.
And all is required is what? Just ID?
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? ID of older than 21, you know what I mean? You of age, boom, you in there, you know what I'm saying? You don't need no medical card, none of that. Just money and a way to get here.
Right.
Like,
don't be so hard on the other generations, man, to like that sour D's, man. See,
you know, come
on. The niggas
that
rock Coogi sweaters want sour diesel.
Listen, that's why they crossed it with, like I said, sour cookies, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's other strands that they cross sour with. I mean, that's you want to smell that sour smell, but it ain't gonna have that sour look, you know what I mean? It's gonna have some exotic look to it, you feel me? Like, that's all it is. Like, a lot of these weeds nowadays is crossed with, you know, the old school weed, you know what I'm saying? It wouldn't be the old school, I mean, it wouldn't be no new school if it wasn't for the old school, you know what I'm saying? So, like, that's how it be, you know?
What's your favorite flavor, just as a smoker, per se? Like, when you wanna get in your zone, what you?
I'm gonna just say indica, you know what I'm saying? Like, anything indica, you know what I'm saying? I throw a little bit of extracts on that shit, you feel me? I'm good to go.
What you mean by extracts?
You know, the wax, the crumble, the moon rock, you know what
right.
I'm saying? I get big hot, you know what I'm saying? Like, I be rolling up probably like $100 L when it comes to the weed that's in it and the extracts.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's me. Like, my tolerance is on a whole nother level, you know what I'm saying, from a regular person that smoke, you know?
Biggie Budds, I'm 100% responsible for introducing you and your brand to the world. Right. I appreciate your time, man. This whole interview was esoteric. This ain't for everybody, but at some point they gonna get it, believe me.
Right.
Appreciate your time again, my nigga.
Well, appreciate you for coming out here, man. Yeah.